This is an addiction test. If you say yes to three or more of these questions, then you have an addiction. At least, according to the American Psychiatric Association. I want to admit that this is slightly abridged. I had to take some things out, and the reality is, it's used for substance abuse, not for porn addiction. If you say yes to two or less, then you can just stop the video and click onto your favorite site. Let's go over each one. Tolerance. That's a strange word, but it means, has your use increased or escalated over time? In other words, do you watch it for more hours? Or have you escalated to more shocking or more extreme porn? Withdrawal. It's not necessary to have withdrawal symptoms if you have an addiction, but most users on our forum do experience some symptoms when they quit. It varies a lot. Could be anxiety, irritability, fatigue, depression. Those are the most common. But some also experience physical symptoms, like cold and flu symptoms, headaches, the inability to sleep, and others. Number 3. Difficulty controlling your use. So, do you use for a longer time than you'd like to? I think that's pretty clear. Self-explanatory. Number 4. Do you understand the negative consequences it does to your mood, to your health? Porn use has been associated with anxiety disorder and sexual dysfunction. Number 5. Neglecting or postponing activities. It means, are you doing porn instead of life? Number 6. The desire to cut down. Now, most addicts say they can quit any time, but they don't. If you've had unsuccessful attempts to cut down, that would be a yes to that question. And last one, number 7. Spending significant time or emotional energy obtaining, using, concealing, planning, or recovering from use. Have you ever concealed your porn use? I think everyone can say yes to that. Here's an explanation on behavioral addictions. It's common knowledge that dopamine-raising substances like alcohol, cocaine, or meth can cause brain changes that lead to addiction. But what about so-called behavioral addictions? These are such things as food, gambling, sex, video games, shopping. Do they cause brain changes that lead to addiction? Well, of course they do. That's why they are addictions. Recent research on gambling, and especially food, has shown brain changes that mimic drug addiction. Internet porn? No one wants to study it. Also, there hasn't been time for many studies, because it's a very recent phenomenon. Now, you tell me, which is more stimulating? Eating cheesecake? Or masturbating to porn? It's known that sex, masturbation, orgasm raise dopamine levels far higher than eating food. Which can you spend more time doing in a day? Eating or edging to porn? Let's talk about natural reinforcers. Natural reinforcer is a fancy word for a non-drug activity that causes dopamine release. That includes food, sex, gambling, video games. Now, if you look at the data, about only 15% or less of drug users, this includes animals too, ever become addicted. Obviously, genes are in play, as are childhood experiences. If you look at natural reinforcers, and of course, food is a powerful one, we have a much higher percentage of people who can become addicted, though it takes a lot longer than it would with addictive drugs. Now, if you think about it, few people want to be fat. Yet, in modern Western cultures, most people are. Now, rats, on the other hand, don't care if they're fat. When they eat Western food, almost all of them overconsume and become obese, not just fat. This suggests two things when it comes to natural reinforcers. Our reward circuitry evolved. It evolved to drive us toward food and sex and not drugs. That's why so many people can potentially get addicted to food and internet porn. And the other thing is that highly stimulating versions of food and sex can hook us even when we're not genetically susceptible to substance addictions. Here's the question. When can natural reinforcers become addictive? Number 1. When they are a highly stimulating version of what our ancestors found really irresistible. Number 2. When something is available in limitless supply. Number 3. It comes in lots of varieties, which is the novelty factor. Number 4. We binge on it without realizing it's triggering brain changes. Now, I think modern food and internet porn fall into all four categories. Both can override our brain's natural satiation mechanisms. The I'm done feeling, And that's because calories and fertilization opportunities really are genes' top priorities. Our limbic system's top priority.